Yo, what is up, guys? Travis, aka Travesty. Today I'm coming at you with an updated grind video for Tungrad Ruins. I'm not the best grinder here. I think every other YouTube video on this grind spot for Awakened Mystic has somebody doing it better than me, but what I can provide is voice commentary as well as just thorough voice commentary as I go through. You'll see that I don't use all the, defensive elixirs. This spot doesn't really hit that hard, so you don't need it. You also know that I have the critical hit damage buff here. I just got that for funsies. So let's go ahead and get into it here. A little horse buff. We'll get our tent. And yeah, let's get it. So we're starting over here. Oops, I fucked up already. Usually I don't start over here, but I just swapped like seven times to find a rotation, and this was up. So there are different paths you can take. If there's only one mob left, I recommend just moving on. Also, try to keep your buff and the green buff up. So what a lot of people like to do for the green buff is they like to do sea burial, and that's what I recommend to get proc this the buff again. Usually, if you're clearing pretty fast, as you go to the next pack, you'll have sea burial buff up. So if you're clearing just fast enough, most of the time your sea burial will indicate when you need to move on, essentially. Now, the combo afterwards, after you get the green buff, is kind of freestyle. Sometimes, if you kill too quickly, the mobs won't CC. And also, you'll notice that I'm having a little bit of a difficulty keeping my 3-shard crouching wolf buff up, unfortunately. And sometimes it's not worth staying for this. So as I get more into the rhythm, I just got back from the gym. As I get more into the rhythm of it, I'll probably leave packs. I'll probably leave packs before. Okay, so I used sea burial there. Unfortunate. Sometimes you're gonna be able to proc it with with Earth Splitter. But as you can see there, it didn't work. In order to like 100% have this mechanic pop, usually you want to be behind the visionary. And as you can see there, I failed the mechanic twice in this, or I'm failing the mechanic quite a bit in this video. You can tell when it is successful is when the mobs die, and I'm literally moving to the next pack with Seagrow up. Again, we're gonna leave that guy. He's not worth the time it would take to kill him. See, these mobs didn't get CC'd, so a little bit harder to kill them. Sometimes I'll use the same combo I use in my Dive and Grind video. Other times I won't. Just got reminded I should probably full screen this so I can do maximum. I like to jump like this. Other people like to do the silent step. Really up to your personal preference. This one is a little bit slower. You can take this pack if you're clearing pretty well. I'm not clearing that fast right now, but just get to know if you're playing a better class or you're like all the other Mystic grind videos on this spot, a lot faster than I am. See here? As soon as your Sea of Burial's up, you kind of want to just move on to the next pack. If you're not clearing properly, it's kind of just your fault. Like here, unfortunate. That was a little bit better. You don't need one shard Sea Burial every time, and then sometimes one shard Sea Burial won't work if you're not fast enough. That's why it's important to always do it with your 10%, your 20% attack casting speed, or if you have Z buff or E buff up, you're chilling. People are texting me right now, but since I started this video, I'll just forego it. Alright, what else is there? If we get a boss spawn soon, we'll talk about it. Usually you want to clear fast enough that you're not sticking around for when they spawn. If the packs are pretty close, that means you're going to have to be killing extremely fast. So here, if the boss had spawned here, and since they didn't properly CC, I would have been fucked. Sometimes you can do crouching wolf back step and then your dashes into the next pack. That can be helpful sometimes. Right on time. Got my Sea Burial up. That was kind of sloppy. Can't be 100% every time, right? The inconsistency of this spot is probably one of my pet peeves. I'm sure there are things you can do, like instead of killing with Wave Orb, you kill with Hurricane Sweep. That makes it so that the mobs actually get CC'd. Like this, but then it's like a lot slower for just like your kill speed in general. Fuck that up. You'll see that I have like 15 seconds left of Z buff, so I won't be E buffing until that's over. So two packs and then I E buff essentially if I'm playing to my Sea Burial timing. Now I do it. This was pretty messy. And that didn't proc. Unfortunate. There are like specific spots you want to go. Once you know the visionary placement, you'll get a little bit cleaner when it comes to just proccing the add-on. Wasted my time here, unfortunate. Sometimes you can do Crouching Wolf into Wave Orb. That's pretty helpful. Just reposition your Wave Orb. And that's about it, boys. Once a boss comes, I'll talk about it a little bit. But let's start the music, which is DMCA free, I think. Or I hope. Sometimes when you fail the Sea Burial, you can do Wave Orb instead. It's a little bit harder because you have to have a little bit better timing with your skills. So I'll show you here. That works most of the time. The since Wave Orb has a longer cooldown, you want to really rely on your Sea Barrel if possible. This was a pretty clean pull right there. If you can kill the pack before your Sea Barrel comes back on cooldown, you're in a really good spot, in my opinion. Really good spot. See here, Sea Barrel came off cooldown, and I'm still struggling to kill these guys. Really bad pull. Like a no shard Sea Burial. Still got it. Make sure you have a 3 shards if at all possible. Sometimes you want to reposition. Getting back attacks here is pretty important. I'm gonna leave that Tungrad because that would have been quite a while of just trying to kill his ass. Okay, brain lag there. Didn't have the skills that I needed. On cooldown. So you'll see that I kind of freestyle my combo. Sure there's like a better way, but I'm gonna do 1-0 trash here, and then depending on how it goes, I might tag a Suck Megu to do the rest of my grind here. Kind of RNG carried right now. We will take that. See that back step crouching wolf? It acts as like 0.75 of a dash. So, if you want to save a single dash, or it's not quite 3 dashes away, you can do Crouching Wolf into it, and pretty helpful, in my opinion. Pretty helpful. Alright, 100% right here. Clean up with Wave Orb. Not quite a 3 shard Sea Barrel right there, but it's fine. The mobs are not CC'd though, so it's actually not fine anymore. That was a bad pull. Another way you can do this rotation is go to the pack to my right, and then come back to this pack. You have to be overclearing pretty hard to justify doing this pack, in my opinion. But sometimes you can do it like that, and then you just do it rotation how it's done over here. Okay, not spending time on that. Was not on cooldown when I needed it. Unfortunate. You see, I kind of go at an angle that, if anything, the Visionary is one of the first hit. If you go at any other angle, most likely the Visionary won't be the first hit, and then you're kind of in a rough spot. see that I still have some PvP skills unlocked like a fucking idiot. Don't do that. I'll just lock your hidden claw, fistery, all that shit. I have it unlocked because I just need to be better enough fat fingering it. Crouching wolf, reposition can help. Use mass destruction reposition. If you're lacking on accuracy here, I'm using 2-pen ominous rings, but if you're lacking on accuracy here, you can do 2-hit mass destruction for some boosted accuracy, of course. I also saw the other Mystic video, which I'll probably link in the description below if you're looking for like a much higher trash per hour video. And in that video, the guy does uses the Roaring Dim Magical Chest, or which has 20 more accuracy on it in comparison to the. So if you ever like fuck up the mechanic, just do the combo I do at Gaifen. Save Sea Burial for the next pack. But yeah, the Roaring Chest is 20 accuracy more or something. Don't know off the top quite. That was kind of a bad entryway. I could have got fucked. The mechanic could have just like bugged on me. That was a clean pull, if I don't say so myself. This pack always has that one motherfucker. I just gave up on winning him. I don't have enough AoE or patience to get his ass. Sometimes when the pack is close enough, I will use Sea Burial. Look. I think that's a boss? No, it wasn't a boss, it's just a notification. Failed the mechanic there. It happens. It's like 100%. Your spiral torpedo AP buff does stack with your buff, but your spiral torpedo buff does not stack with your buff, just a fun. Since the AP you get is all AP on the Dragonite buff, all AP on the spiral torpedo buff. If spiral torpedo was melee AP and then E-buff was all AP, it would stack, but unfortunately. Failed the mechanic there, but still was able to kill before my Sea Burial was off cooldown. It's pretty good, pretty good. see that I'm consistently leaving one guy back. Waken Mystic, really not going to have the best time getting all the mobs at once unless you reposition your attacks and quickly identify which way they're turned. Since I have the telescope now, I can't be bothered to continue to kill. But I'm sure if you're like on the telescope ground, you don't want to leave those executioners like that. Kinda fucked this bull up. I didn't activate the mechanic and I ulted. The pace for something like 18k? 6 times 3? Maybe 19k? 6.7 times 3 is 2.1? Damn it, I shouldn't have stayed for that motherfucker. Need to crouching wolf 3 shards, but it can be helpful to get that extra little speed buff. A crouching wolf with 2 shards is totally fine if you're just canceling in 2-wave orb. Mess up and keep messing up like I just did, you're not gonna get a record trash hour. Earth Splitter sometimes works to get the mechanic down. Sometimes. If it was more consistent and had a little bit longer AoE, I'd probably use it more often. It can be nifty to get behind them. Guess that turn. Except this guy did. I'm like focusing right now. Not streaming. Making a YouTube video. Okay, we got a boss. If I don't kill these guys quick enough, the boss mobs are gonna come this way, and it's gonna be fucked. Now I think I'm far enough away that I can kill that guy, that pack. But if I had fucked it up a lot more than I am fucking up, that would have been. Because then I'd have to kill them there and then, or the thing disappears. That's spawn number one. I fucked this up super bad. Sometimes you can do spiral torpedo cancel. It's not as smooth as the other ones, but it's a new app. So if you want to use it, practice using it. Right. Not the worst. Not the worst. Probably shouldn't have spent my time wasted on that guy. But sometimes you just zone out a little bit. Hotbar crouching wolf into wave orb is pretty good. Not gonna lie. I gotta be quick with this. The packs are so close. If I don't kill this really fucking quick, I think I'm good. I think I'm good. But yeah, if you're not perfect on that pool, yeah, you're fucked. You're gonna have to kill the boss right then and there. And the reason why you want to push so hard on clearing it quick is because the green buff helps you clear out the event mobs really good. Yeah, I'm leaving. I didn't clear it perfectly, but it's totally fine. Rather than hit one of the event mobs and have them despawn on me, I'm gonna wait until I go back there. One boss. Here's my first boss. And bosses do boost trash up quite a bit. Try to focus down the boss mobs so that utilize the green buff as long as you can. I have 13 seconds left of it. The faster you clear it, the faster it summons. Looks like my green buff is gone, now they're gonna die a little bit slower. And this is why you really want to maximize that green buff spacing. Green buff, because once... This is where like having big AoEs would be nice. And then after an event like that, you're just gonna have to do a regular combo. Try to save your sea burial for initiating the next pack. But of course, if you accidentally use it, totally fine. That's one boss. We might hit a 20k. So, if we keep up the boss luck, we might be able to hit 20k. That was a risky cancel. Wave Orb was just coming off cooldown right there. If my ping is any higher, that was just gonna straight up fail. There, I misjudged how long Hurricane Sweep would take to get off the last kick, so I stood there like an idiot trying to charge away from. these mobs down as quickly as possible. These mobs are so close that as soon as your green buff wears out, you can do this next pack. And be chilling. Come back and kill those guys. Just like that. They're so close, you can do this. That way you keep your green buff while you kill these guys. So you kind of get lucky and unlucky depending on if you can leave before the boss spawns the mobs. Because if you hit at least one of them, you don't have to kill it. If you hit it and move on, it despawns. And yeah, green buff has run out now. Could be a little bit better on that one for sure. Debuff. Mobs are pretty damn close. These mobs are not spawning. Yes. I don't know where my green buff is. Really only if you know you can come, if they're close enough, you can do this mechanic. Mob, this boss is not spawning these mobs as quickly as I would like. Sometimes it feels like it's RNG how quickly these guys spawn up. So I think that's three bosses now. I think average per hour is like six. Depending on clear speed. I think for me it's around 6-ish. A little bit lower sometimes, a little bit higher. Leaving two mobs is usually an F. One mob is kind of standard for Mystic, two is feels kind of bad. You could definitely have cleaned it up a little bit. Actually, no. This guy came in. Oh my god. That was a fail. Made up for it, though. Probably one of the worst packs I have to do. It's always because that one guy's kind of far. I wonder what I could do to make it better. So actually pull. This is gonna be tough. Definitely failed it. This is a bad pack. All of them are low, none of them got CC'd, and it took me 3 to 4 seconds longer than it usually takes me to kill. That's when you know you didn't do a good job. Just 100%ed. That was a bad Eva. Whatever. Too far away. Didn't have as many shards as I needed. Definitely freestyle the combo a little more than it needs to be. When I'm grinding, though, I'm watching the shows. That wasn't that bad. That's pretty bad. Keep killing the guy. I think they should really change the mechanic on this guy so that as soon as he dies, they all get CC no matter what. The inconsistency on this guy makes it pretty annoying to grind here. If you're going for, like, optimization. Thank you. bad rotations there. And this is why I can never hit 20k. But I killed these guys slow enough that it was back up. It's time to do this. More often than not, those will bug. Or you won't have enough raw AP to just get the job done. Yeah, I left immediately when I saw that guy spawn. That's how you should do it. Stuck on the rock. And that makes this pack slow. Such a random rock to get stuck on, right? 25. Correct me in the comics so I'm wrong. 12 minutes left, boys. 12 minutes left. Oh, I love that. I love that. Yeah, they're not too sweet. Classic. Classic. There. Probably because Wave Orb was not on cooldown when I flopped Reawakening. It's the little things, guys. The little things that differentiate me between the better grinders on the Mystic. I hate that pack right there, bro. That pack sucks. Get here in time after all. And grind in peace. Such a bad boy right here, guys. Sometimes I wish the Wake Mystic just had a little Just a little bit more AoE. Just a little bit more AoE. And she'd be like perfect for this spot. Just a little bit more AoE, buddy. Not get killed. Another boss I think we can hit. I think if we get another boss, I can hit 20k in this video. Guy. classic fucking up the last 2 minutes. Feels fucking great. Okay, boys. First time hitting that. Oh, the crit damage buff. Last pack. Just like that. 1 hour is over, boys. 20k, 20.5. We had 5 bosses. Not the worst, not the best, but hope you guys found this pseudo grind video pretty helpful with my commentary. We'll be linking better Mystic grind videos in the video. Of course, mine is the only one with commentary. I don't think I've seen a single other Mystic talk while they grind. It's usually some Korean K-pop, Japanese music type shit. Anyways, appreciate y'all for stopping by, and catch you guys in the next one. Look at that telescope, man. Looks pretty damn good to me.
Peace.